morning and welcome to Higher Hope Church Online. As you can see, it is Teen Sunday, a day that all of us teens look forward to. But it also happens to be Father's Day. Happy Father's Day to all the dads out there, the people who sacrifice their time and give us all the support and love that we need. We wouldn't be who we are without you guys. So with that, will you worship with us?
Worship our King. Come, let us bow at His feet. He has done great things. See what our Savior has done. See how His love overcomes. He has done great things. He has done great.
For this day, thank you for all that you are doing in our lives. We thank you for all the fathers. We thank you for all that they do for us. And we thank you that you are keeping us safe. You're watching over us and protecting us. And we just thank you for all that you do. Amen.
Down, eating your soul. I know a place
where mercy flows. Take the stains, make them whiter than snow. Like a tide, it is rising up deep inside a current that moves and makes you come alive. Living water brings a dead to life. Whoa, whoa, oh. We're going down to the river, down to the river, down to the river to pray, yeah, hey. To be washed by the water, washed by the water, and rise up in amazing grace. Let's go down, down, down to the river, you will be changed. Let's go down, down, down to the river, never the same. I seen it move in my own life, took me from dusty roads into paradise. All of my dirt, all of my shame, drowned in the streams that made me born again. Like a tide, it is rising up deep inside a current that moves and makes you come alive. Living water brings the dead to life. Whoa, whoa, oh. We're going down to the river, down to the river.
Good morning. We're so glad you could join us. Happy Father's Day. And this service is a little different. Every Father's Day, we have our teens take over the church. This year obviously looks a little different, but we still were able to incorporate them in a lot of different ways. We especially want to honor our seniors as they are heading on to the next phase of their life. So you'll see a lot of seniors and a lot of celebration for them as we go through the service. So we invite you to honor them with us, as well as see just how talented our youth is and how on fire they are for God. Let's just pray before we start. God, I thank you so much for all that you've done for us, especially during this season. And we're so thankful that we can still do these kinds of things. We're so thankful we can still honor you and honor our seniors and honor all of our teens within our church. I pray that you continue to lift them up, to give them the passion and the purpose that they have for their life, and to continue to glorify you in all that you do. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. And all my days have been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest nights, you are close like no other. as a father. I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God
all my life.
And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. When my life lay down, I surrender now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. When my life lay down, I surrender now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness.
Thank you.
don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop.
Have for me. feet are frozen on this middle ground. The water's warm here, but the fire's gone out. I played it safe for so long, the passion left. Turns out safe is just another word for regret. So I step to the edge and I take a deep breath. We're all down to live, but we're all scared to death. And this is the part where my head tells my heart to shut. I'm going all child, well done. So I step to the edge and I take a deep breath.
I'm Eli Schooley. I am the son of the pastor, and I just graduated Horsehead High School. To start it off, I just wanted to say three things that I learned about being the pastor's kid. The first one, I get told to do the message on Sunday, on Youth Sunday. The second, my family does make fun of my dad for using his hand signals all the time, so keep messing with him with that. And number three, I am expected to be perfect, which is the only one I have done so far. My class in 2020 has experienced more than any other class. We were born right after 9/11, and our senior year has been going right through this quarantine. It's definitely something that a lot of other people haven't lived through. We're going to use it as a moment for the rest of our life. The college I'm going to is Karen University. The definition of a cairn is a mound of rough stones built as a memorial or landmark, typically on a hilltop or skyline. So as this year, this moment could be used as a cairn. Karens can be seen throughout both the Old and New Testament. One of the most influential Karens built I have seen is in Joshua. The Israelites have been wandering the desert for 40 years, and they reach the river, the Jordan River, and then God parts it for them, and they walk across. And the verse in Joshua 4:1 says, "When the whole nation had finished crossing the Jordan, the Lord said to Joshua, 'Choose 12 men from among the people, one from each tribe, and tell them to take up 12 stones from the middle of the Jordan, from right where the priests are standing, and carry them over with you, and put them down at the place where you stay tonight.'" This moment for the Israelites was big. They found the promised land finally, and they wanted to mark it with a Karen, which to me is pretty special. This year, all the seniors will be put in an item in the box, and this is going to be used as a Karen for them, a moment item that is monumental to them. Previous years, they have used, some people have put other items in, like this bracelet. This bracelet is from Ryan Clement, and the verse is, "In the same way, let your light shine before others that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven." This is very big for the seniors, and all these items will have a meaning for the rest of their life.
Hi, I'm Michaela Nelson, and I just graduated from Corning Painted Post High School. I plan on going to CCC for college. So I have two pictures here that I will be putting in the capsule. This one is a picture of my cap that I made this year. It says, "I'm standing here today because you helped me find my way." And it has a whole bunch of pictures of all my friends and family, people close to me that helped me get through life. And then this other picture is of me twirling a fire baton, showing that the braveness that I have, also like the courage and the willing to do and try new things.
Hi, my name is Chesney Martin. My next plan is to get a job and then eventually go to culinary school. What I'm putting in Time Castle is a picture of when I got adopted. My favorite verse is Jeremiah 29:11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope in the future."
I am Brad, and I'm going to tell you what I'm putting a shoelace from my soccer cleat, and putting in the time capsule because I met all my friends from soccer, and that's what I'm going to do. And I want to get a job sometime and go travel all 50 states.
My name is Patrick Smith. I just graduated from Horseheads High School. I'm going to St. John Fisher to study sports management with a minor in business. My time capsule item is the picture after we beat Corning in the newspaper, us celebrating. It's significant because it was like one of my best high school memories and one of the best times in high school.
I'm Melissa French. I go to Horseheads High School, and my plans after graduation, I'll be going to CCC for childhood education. And something that's been a huge part of my life for the past 6 or 7 years is running. So I'm putting one of my running bibs in the time capsule. And my Bible verse is, "All things are possible if you believe." And I think that's an important thing to remember in both running and real life.
I'm Bryce Perez. I graduated from Horseheads High School, and I'm going to be going to the University of Buffalo for architecture. And my object I'm putting in is a blank piece of canvas, because art has been a big part of my life since my whole life, and it's just representing me wanting to continue that through college.
My name's Alyssa Walker. I'm going to be graduating from Notre Dame High School, and after high school, I'll be going to Cornell University to study human development. My time capsule item is a running medal from probably one of the most memorable races of my high school career. and my Bible verse is Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Don't depend on your own understanding, which is just kind of like, it's really important in the sport I do to kind of just remember to always trust God in the process.
Hi, my name is Claire Sadler. I'll be graduating from Horseheads High School today, and I am going to be going to CCC for nursing and then continuing my education and then going to law school. I'm putting in a Nerf bullet because the youth ministry has really impacted my life, and we used to play a lot of night games with the Nerf guns and everything. And it also represents the children's ministry where I will be continuing to serve throughout the rest of my life.
Hi, I'm Gabriel Prince. I graduated from Williamson High School, and I'm going to be going on to Mansfield University to hopefully major in communications and possibly become a flight attendant. These are a pair of sunglasses that I got from graduating, and they really represent my entire journey, I guess, to here. So I think that the majority of the time that I spent at Williamson wasn't exactly how I would have had it. And this is probably the greatest reward that I've got through all of graduation, and it makes me pretty happy. So I give it to the time capsule.
Hi, I'm Eli Schooley. I just graduated Horseheads High School, and I'll be going to Caron University to play baseball and study business management and a minor in sports management. I'll be putting in my bracelet from Dominican Republic. We gave these out to little kids that really enjoyed them, and that really was something that really impacted me when I went down there. And my life verse is Philippians 4:12-13. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do everything through him who gives me strength.
As we send off our seniors, we just want to pray over them. Would you pray with me? God, I thank you for these seniors and all that you've done in their life, the people that you continue to pour into them and to invest in them. And Lord, I pray that they continue to surround themselves with godly people, that they're able to get the wisdom and value from these people. Lord, I pray your protection over them as they head off to college or a job or into an internship, that you are just in them and through them and that you're reflected by them. I pray that they glorify you in all that they do. I pray that as they continue on in life, that they understand just what you have done for them and that they declare the gospel over it all. We pray your blessing on them and their life, and that you give them all of their heart's desire as they align themselves with you and your will for them. Please make their calling just clear to them as they walk through, and they know that the purpose that you have given them is for your glory. We pray for them as they go on, that they are successful in all that they do, and that they have successful families as they go forward, and successful relationships and friendships, and they continue to find people that are full of godly wisdom that can just surround them as they move forward. We thank you for all you've done for them. It's in your name we pray. Amen. We thank you that you were able to join us for the service. Following the service, we have a bunch of parent messages for our seniors, so please stick around and watch those. Have a great week.
Hey, Alyssa, we just wanted to come and let you know how much we love you, how much we're proud of you. Congratulations on your graduation. Again, we are very proud of you. You've overcome a lot these last 4 years. We wish you the very best.
Yes, congratulations, Alyssa. We love you very much. We're very proud of you. And just wish you continued success in life. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay
Patrick, Patchy Boy, Pete, all meaning the same thing. Amazing. We knew 18 years ago when God gave you to us that we got the most special gift. We have been so proud of you every step of the way. It's hard to believe that June of 2020 is here and you are graduating from high school. You are ready for the next journey. Please approach it with confidence, with pride, and with commitment. You have the ability to make great things happen. Use the talent that God has given you to make a difference with the people around you. And know to always make time for a little fun, a little laughter, and always know that you are so loved. We love you, God.
6 years ago, I wrote you a letter, and what was in that letter holds true today. The letter read, "Patrick, your mother and I are so very proud of you. You have excelled in your young life as a great athlete, a great student, and a great son. The other day, before a basketball tournament, you told us that you don't get nervous before games anymore. Well, this test that you are about to take is like any sporting tournament that you've ever been in. I can tell you I'm not nervous because I know you will do the best you can, just like you always have. And that's how you're going to do at St. John Fisher. I love you."
Hi Patrick, there are so many things that you have going for you that are going to make you successful after high school. You have an amazing work ethic and you try to make yourself and all of us proud of you in everything that you do. You can talk to anyone and just have a comforting presence about you that people are drawn to. You will drop anything that you're doing to help someone in need. There are so many other things like your humor and your quick wit and just ability to make anyone laugh. And it's all of these things that make me so proud to be your sister. I love you so much. You are going to do amazing things after high school and I'm so, so proud of you.
Hi Patchy, I love you so much. I'm so proud of everything you've accomplished in your 18 years. I hope your senior year was amazing. Happy graduation. Love ya.
I've been thinking about time and where does it go? How can I stop my life from passing me by? I don't know. I've been thinking about family, how it's going so fast. Will I wake up one morning just wishing that I could go back? I've been thinking about lately, maybe I can make a change and let it change me. So with all of my heart, this is my prayer. Singing, oh Lord, keep me in the moment. Help me live with my eyes.
Eli, so you know as your mom that I sometimes have a hard time processing you leaving in a few months. And just all the changes that will happen in our family and all the laughs that happen. But I have watched you get excited and happy about your new adventure coming up in the next year. And that makes me change my perspective from being sad to being happy about what's going to happen in your life. And I prayed since you were very young that God would do a good work in you. And it's so exciting to see those things happening. And I'm really excited to see in the next few years what God has for you. We are so proud of you and we love you. And one note, don't forget to call your mom, okay?
Eli, you have gone on an adventure with us for the last 18 years and we've loved all the moments of it, from starting a church that you were part of, from waving a flag at one of our first events, to passing out water, to setting up Tear Down. You have covered it all at church, even in turning the summer. You've gone on an adventure of Little League with me, all the way up through all the different times I coached and got to watch you and travel baseball. We did the adventure of the DR together, and just how exciting it was to see you grow in that trip and experience what God has for you there. We've done Syracuse games together and got to watch some great losses and a few wins along the way. But we are excited for what God has done in you, and I'm really excited about what God is going to do to you, knowing that your adventures may not always include us now, but they're going to be incredible adventures that God has for you. And so our prayer for you is that God will do more than we ask or imagine according to his power that's at work in you. And so we're excited about what God has planned, and I hope that you keep him centered in your life, because he's the one that brings the greatest adventures to all that you will do. And so we love you, we're proud of you, and we're excited about what God has for you.